how do I know if my dog is overheating?
You know, I don't know that I can give a clear-cut answer about, like, how do you know? Well, like, your dog is probably panting pretty hard and breathing pretty heavily, right? You know, that's one, that's probably the one that I would see the most, that, hey, there's very, very heavy respiration.
Yeah.
What do you think? Like,
well, I know that, for instance, if you're walking your dog in dead summer, and if they, like, lay down in the middle of your walk, then they're, like, you need to carry them home.
Yeah.
Like, don't try and be conscious, because people don't, you know.
Like, there's a really sad story, and this is a former client of mine, and he passed away, I'm not sure how long ago he passed away, but he had he was in a motorized chair, and he had his dog with him, the first dog that I worked with. He had his service dog with him, and the dog was pretty well conditioned, but the guy just, he kept trucking, towing the dog behind him, and the dog went into heat stroke and did not survive. And man, it just, like, you know, broke my heart, broke his heart. That's just a really terrible situation to be in. But, you know, I don't know that I can give you clear-cut things. Like, your dog's respiration is probably the major one, but don't exert them in all this heat. You know, we had a really good video this week, or maybe last week, where I was talking about the 5-second rule, that if you can't put your hand down on the concrete for more than 5 seconds, then you can't go for a walk with your dog. And this is one great way to prevent heat exhaustion. Well, you know, several times this week I went out and we said, well, I want to see your walk, but we're not going to go for a walk. And we'd go out there, we put our hand down, and lo and behold, we couldn't go. Mm-hmm. And as a matter of fact, I'm going to tell you guys right now, one time this week I followed the 5-second rule. We went out, put our hand down, 5 seconds, oh, it was good, we went, and then maybe 10 minutes into the walk, the dog suddenly pulled over into the grass and lay down. Mm-hmm. And I was like, okay, what's going on? And I put my hand down on the concrete, and I could only make it to 2. We picked the dog up, and we carried the dog all the way back.
Some serious heat here in Texas.
You know, it's pretty serious, guys. So even if you follow the 5-second rule, maybe you go 5 or 6 minutes and then you check it again, because that concrete can get real hot real fast. One, you don't want to burn your pads up, but hey, heaven forbid, man, don't kill your dog.
Yeah, I know. We don't realize that. I mean, they're not just
like, and that's
us.
Not like any one of us wants to do that. Like, nobody that's watching this, you know, or is a client of ours wants to.
Well, we think if we're going to be, you know, if we're okay, our dog's okay, but that's not.
But that's not the case, you know. Like, yeah, they've got a coat and we don't.
We have shoes, and
probably the majority of the dogs that our clients have don't, you know, necessarily wear those boots that are going out there. So, you know, hey, you know, just be real conscientious. You know, walk early in the day, walk late in the day, check the concrete before you go out, make sure your dog's getting plenty of water throughout the day, and then watch the respiration, but be paying attention. You know, don't pay attention too much to your phone or anything else that's going on. I don't want to throw the phone under the bus, because I'm on my phone quite a bit all the time. But hey, you got to pay attention to your dog. You know, your dog cannot communicate to you the way that a human can. And so you really got to read their body language. Your eyes have to be on them. So that's, you know, that's what I recommend there.
Yep.